Hello and welcome to Christmas at Uni. So it's the last week of term for the undergraduates here at Exeter, which means there's a lot of Christmas events going on this week. As a PhD, I never really have to leave, like there's no term times, but this week's going to be busy. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. So some of you complained that there was too much singing and not enough science in the last video. This video, I'm going to try and keep singing down to a relative minimum, considering that we're doing three services this week. My objectives are to continue to not be a little bitch, because I was quite successful at not being a little bitch last week, and actually got some thesis done, so I'm going to continue with that work. I only actually just got from Belfast for my top secret filming a couple of days ago, so basically, actually, we're picking up where we left off because I was a bit busy for the past week. So finalize what I was doing, get that like locked in, I can move on. I also want to talk to you guys about some of the techniques that I'm using. So I'm determined to try and get some of my coding woes sorted this week. It's going to be this week or next week. I've only got, I think, 12 weeks until I want to get a good first draft done of the thesis. And there's a lot to do in those 12 weeks, and it's basically all contingent on me actually getting this code to work. This morning I've already done a lot of organisation and emails and sifting through code to find some fragments that I need to use again. I really should document my stuff better. And now it's lunchtime, I've organised some caroling for the chapel choir because we need to capitalise on the fact that people only seem to think that chapel choirs exist at Christmas, so we've got to kind of convince people that we do year round. Chapel choir is not just for Christmas kids, it's for life.
Hello, lovely.
Hello, how are you? Are you vlogging again?
I am. Do you want to be in this one as well? Imogen, I really hope that there's going to be a display in the forum today. Oh man. We're now going to have lunch, and yes, we have a presse manger on campus. We're very middle class. I'm not, but the uni is. Liv's just pointed out that I am this soup.
We're having a chapel choir lunch.
This is Hugo.
You're gonna do a classic zoom in.
Yeah, let me do a classic zoom in. Hugo, what happened to you on the weekend? Did you or did you not lock yourself in a toilet?
The toilet locked myself in the toilet. It was.
You're not an English student, are you?
Can we just take a moment to analyse that sentence? That is
brilliant. I may or may not have been locked in the toilet for 45 minutes.
Yeah, you messaged me and I didn't even notice for 15 minutes. It was just lots of messages saying, help. What you say?
It was quite funny. Ed passed me beer through the window. It was great.
And you get locked in.
Amazing. Daniel, what did you do that night?
What did I do that night?
You went native with the Italians.
Oh, I did, yeah.
It does. What I mean by that is he did a shot of what was meant to be Jaeger, and it turned out it wasn't Jaeger, it was olive oil.
I made a severe judgment call error. You will get a little feeling when you hear voices singing, let's be jolly,
deck the halls with boughs of holly. It's actually amazing just how much of your time can be taken up. Like, I'm not even a professor or anything. I'm a PhD student. It's amazing how much time is taken up by just admin. Today I was submitting paperwork for being reimbursed for the big YouTube project that I'm working on, which a trailer will come up for eventually. And then also just replying to emails about meetings and all that kind of stuff, and just getting myself organised. That took the best part of the entire morning. Now it's time for me to record some videos for the YouTube channel. Like, I actually will, because I'm not hungover. Okay, so I just filmed a Q&A. That's what my setup looks like, by the way. It's a bit gorilla. That's a softbox with a sheet over it because it was too bright. I also had another light over here, and then this was on a tripod for once. And then I also used this NTG2, which is my default microphone for anything with like decent quality, which is going into a Zoom H4n. Now I think I've got enough time to actually record another video tonight, which is going to be the book club. So I'm going to change to give it the impression that I didn't actually film everything on the same day, and then we're going to get on with editing. Fashion.
So last night I left some computer code running that was repeating something that I did about 2 years ago, which is a very important part of the data we're using. So say you're interested in temperature in the atmosphere, right? And how temperature changes as you go up. Now, the normal way that people do things is that you will look at the temperature on pressure surfaces. So where the pressure that is 1,000 hectopascals, or 100 hectopascals, or 50 hectopascals, whatever, in the atmosphere as you go up, you'll measure the temperature and you can plot that. So you're plotting temperature against pressure. And there's various reasons for why. Basically, it makes the equation simpler. We're not interested in doing that, though. What we want to do is examine data, say temperature, on constant height surfaces. Now, that's something of a problem when you don't get data supplied from where you download these data sets from. In that format, you have to calculate it. What is supplied, however, is the height of the pressure surfaces that you get the data from. So 1,000 hectopascals, 150, whatever. So the program that I was running overnight was taking the information of the pressure surfaces, what height they're at, and then interpolating, so basically filling in the gaps, and resampling that data at constant height surfaces like 1 kilometer, 5 kilometers, 20 kilometers. Now I did this once at the start of the PhD, and it literally took 2 weeks. I literally just had to set the script running, and it was gonna go for 2 weeks. This time around, however, now the reason it was so much faster this time is that I've got a lot better at coding in the two or three years that's been since I first wrote code to do that task. It's just a lot more efficient the way I'm using the memory. Also, I'm now using a different language. This code is in Python, which is kind of much more built for this sort of thing, really. Before I used R, which is a statistical language that's very useful for looking at the statistics of large data sets, but not so much for manipulating them. This incidentally brings the number of languages used in this PhD up to 3. Well, 4 if you count English. Those 3 being R, Python, and Fortran 90. Peter, why are we in a primary school classroom with Peter? We've just disrobed. That went pretty well, I think. That's the first one down.
This is Dr. Jones, our organist. Dr. Jones, how do you feel about glissandos?
Corin,
I must say, you were exceptional. You were very, very... I got some in the rehearsal, so I'll put some in now.
The star shines out with a steadfast
God, it's bright. So one of the key characteristics of a vlog is honesty. You don't necessarily share everything in your life, in fact it's not healthy to, but when you do share something, it's important to be honest about it. So, in all honesty, I slept through my alarm this morning, I got into campus late, I'm just wearing a t-shirt, and I didn't even bother shaving, feel a bit tatty, and I totally forgot that I meant to be giving a talk today about vlogging to some quite important people. I only remembered this 40 minutes before I meant to go on. I meant to be on very soon. So there you go, that's some honesty. Not that this meeting isn't important to me and that I'm not taking it seriously. I just kind of forgot. My mental RAM's just getting very full, I think.
Rick is giving the talk, and Rick is for a company which proves that you can copy so.
Well, that went pretty well, I think. The great thing about giving talks at these conferences is they always have free food. So that was my talk on making online video specifically for sort of outreach for students, and about how the highest production value isn't actually the best production value. It's a talk I've given a couple of times now, so they certainly seem to like it. They said we got the recommendation from this person and we can definitely see why, so good. Oh God, there are people on campus trying to hand out things. I hate it when people try to hand things out on campus.
Listen to hear sleigh bells
snow. All right, it's time for the last even song of term.
When he is king, we will give him that
kiss. So I just got back from having dinner with a girlfriend at the campus pub, and I am now watching this week's Yogscast reference. I'm watching the Jingle Jam live stream with Hat Films. If you're watching this in December, consider donating to the Jingle Jam. They do a lot of good work. They've raised over $1 million so far, and you can get yourself, I think it's $650 worth of gains if you donate $30. So it's just a good investment, really. So a bunch of people just asked me on Twitter about my programming stuff, and this seems to have caused confusion about whether I'm like a programming or a physics PhD. Most science PhDs, I think, there's a lot of programming done, particularly if you're looking at large data sets like in climate. So I've taught myself basically all my programming stuff. My dad taught me a little bit of HTML, and I remember pestering him continually about whether we could do more HTML, and like I wanted to build a web page. I did this course on C in Oxford, which kind of taught what programming is, like it's just a sequence of instructions. But then everything since then, I have just taught myself by Googling, really. So I did my master's project was in MATLAB, which was an entirely new language to me, and I quite like, actually, despite the hate that it gets. Before then, I also did a project in IDL, which was my summer research project, which made me do a PhD, or rather I took the summer research project at the Atmospheric Physics Department in Oxford, because I wanted to see if a PhD would be for me. Fortran's the new one, which we're now using to try and speed up the code that does the PV inversion, and it's kind of unlike any of the other ones that I've looked at. Well, I hope that cleared up the, like, programming confusion. I wish someone would clear up my programming confusion. Just a quick note to all the people who are commenting on these videos saying they're really inspirational. How on earth do I have time for this? How on earth do I not get really tired after, like, lack of sleep? I am exhausted basically all the time. Particularly at the moment, I seem to be really wiped. If you want to take motivation from this, I keep doing these things. I keep working on my thesis, and I keep making videos because I want to do those things. And I'm not gonna let something like me being a bit tired stop me. And it's also important to let you guys know that I'm not some kind of Superman. I am very frail and human. And there are definitely times when I just sleep in and I just physically can't work because I push myself too far. I still fail all the time, but I don't let that stop me from doing what I want to do. Okay, today is going to be a good day. It's raining. Okay, today's going to be a pretty great day. So, I just had a video go live, my 40k subs Q&A. So, channel's in good hands. I'm going to work all morning on trying to fix the boundary condition problem that my code's been having. We've then got a bit of busking to do with chapel choir in the forum. Then it's back to work all afternoon working on the code. Hopefully, today, it's going to work. Then it's the big chapel choir Christmas service, 9 lessons and carols this evening. And then after that, it's the chapel choir Christmas meal, where I imagine everyone's going to get very bevved. So a bit of a slow start to the day today. I kept getting distracted by the comments on the new video I uploaded. This always happens. Whenever I upload a new video, I always keep checking it like every 5 minutes. Also, the entire office got distracted because Blanca, one of the postdocs in the office, got a new calendar. Wait a minute. Blanca, what is this? Did you buy this for yourself?
It's a grand calendar. No, it was a gift.
They're just doing so well.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, dad photo.
I think you're all enjoying this a little bit too much. Now it's time for a burst of caroling. What's the problem, Dan?
Oh, I don't know. I just love fun too much.
Did you have a few drinks again last night?
No. Yeah.
Don't make him cry.
Are you still a little bit drunk now?
Yes.
I've also got to learn the Gouda taste solo for tonight.
Oh, shit. Oh no, you can't put that in.
I'll just block it. It's fine. I can't put you in. It's fine. I'll just block this one.
Come have your
There we go. Whoa. Guess which one of us just walked into a tree?
Oh my God.
Was it the drunk one? No, sadly not.
Bam, you're going to walk into a tree.
I did the right. I told you.
Everyone bear witness.
Who are we looking at?
Jessie.
Oh, is it the Jessie tree? This is one of our choristers. Is in this seminar room. There she is. Keep going.
Think of many skies, lonely angels singing.
Well, isn't that pretty?
Okay, so in the afternoon I was working on applying some new boundary conditions to a four transcript that I'm working on, which inverts the PV. Not quite there yet. Now it is time for me to go to our big carol service. It's worth saying that when most people think about Christmas services, they think about carols, and this is a nine lessons and carols service, there's lots of them. But there's also some absolutely sublime music that's written for this time of year that's a lot more interesting than carols. So I've made a playlist, that'll be down there in the description, if you'd like to listen to some of that, including some stuff that we are singing tonight.
Wait a minute, in the chapel? Is that?
Aurora Borealis! At this time of year, at this time of day.
There are going to be a lot of candles in this service.
Corin, what are you wearing under your cassock?
I'm wearing absolutely nothing.
Oh my god! I feel there are a few things I need to explain about this meal. Half of the table just descended into madness over duck-based jokes after what happens if you cross Father Christmas and a duck resulted in the answer of
this will not translate well in your video.
No.
It's really a you had to be there kind of thing. I'm here, I'm still not sure.
We also did our Secret Santa. I got a really cool mug. Peter!
Why did I buy you suntan lotion for your Secret Santa? Where do I start?
Is it because your bat looked like a half-peeled orange after our tour to Malta?
Firstly,
on the flight home, did we nearly divert the flight to a different airport so you could go to a hospital because you were so badly sunburned?
No, we had. My mind is made of this incident.
Also, somebody got our organist, Dr. Jones, a Justin Bieber calendar.
Goodbye, the internet. So it's nighttime now for Simon. Bye bye. I'm sleepy. Oh, I'm kind of gay.
Okay, so I definitely just got out of something that I again forgot I had to do. The university has some online video resources to do with various topics, like doing a PhD, and they were interviewing me for that. I was literally leaving the building, and then I looked at the number on the lift, and I was like, level 7. Oh!
So this is going on the PGR website, is it?
Yeah, it's going on the Ellie page. So basically, at the moment, we have kind of like...
So that's done now, anyway. Is there anything else I can forget this week? Today, I really wasn't very productive, because over the past couple of days, my YouTube channel has gone insane. Like, mad. For context, about a month ago, I was getting of the order 3,000, 5,000 views a day. Very, very happy with that. I thought, you know, this is going great. YouTube's going pretty good. Over the past 48 hours, I've had 220,000 views. And part of it is undoubtedly doing weekly vlogs. Also, changes to the YouTube's algorithm, I think. But at any rate, things have just exploded, and it is incredibly distracting because I feel I have an obligation to people who comment on my videos, particularly if they ask a question, to reply and engage with them. And I was getting a comment about every 2 minutes. I'm really still struggling to process this because it is just such a big shift. My subscriber base has gone up by something like 10,000 people in the past couple of weeks. So naturally, I'm obsessively checking analytics and seeing if this surge has stopped, when it's going to stop, if comments are coming in, replying to people. It is very distracting. Not that I'm complaining about it, I just need to learn to get a bit more disciplined when it comes to work and YouTube and trying to keep them separate. On the work side, I didn't have a supervision today because my supervisor is at the Met office, so sent him a big email with all the stuff that I've been working on. And I'm now heading home because I need to do some housekeeping, like getting a load of washing on and things like that, and doing some work on my laptop at home, and then going on a date.
I think I've opened five. Have you opened six?
No.
No, I've opened four.
Oh, did you open five?
I think I did.
Oh, you did?
Oh, I did, sorry.
So, one of the perks of coming home is that Dan's mum bought us both advent calendars. And that's his hand. And, what have you just got?
I just put it in my mouth. Oh. You haven't had five yet, have you?
I've got like a squid. Is it?
I don't think it's a squid.
The lobster?
Yeah!
In the nativity play?
Yeah. First lobster.
So I just had a really hot date with the girlfriend. We went to a really cool burger place where we haven't gone for how long actually? About a year. It's really good. If you're in Exeter, get a hub box. It's pretty cool.
How do you feel about going to the cinema?
I feel peng. I feel.
How peng?
So pen.
You just said pen.
I so pen. I'm so ready to write about this.
Say something interesting then. You're the worst vlogger ever.
The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. I'm not alone this time. I just realised that we never gave our review of Arrival. I really love this film. I think it's some really intelligent sci-fi that the genre really needs. If you're interested in sci-fi whilst it's in cinemas, try and go and see it, because seeing on a big screen and hearing the sound and music of it in a cinema is kind of conducive to it. Liv really liked it as a linguist, and definitely the bits that were most interesting, I also think, were the sections about language. Dan, interestingly, wasn't quite so uniformly positive about it. It's definitely not perfect. I completely agree with him about that, but I really liked it. So I travelled for a couple of hours this morning to come to my great uncle's 90th birthday party. Happy birthday, Uncle George. He's 90, let's face it, he's probably not watching YouTube videos.
Toast to absent friends. There's Anne and Donnie, and Jess and Ellie, and Bob.
Bob's here.
Rob. Rob.
Rob.
That's debatable. Rob and Laura, yeah.
Happy birthday, dear George. Happy birthday to you!
Yay! Let's see if I can fit in the frame with you guys.
Wait, are we doing everyone in the frame?
Put your hands up if you've got a YouTube channel.
Yay!
Oh, you do too! I didn't realise you did. Okay, so you're obviously watching mine. These are my cousins.
I make intros and do GoPro vlogs.
And you edit better than me, and how old are you?
12, nearly 13.
You're literally half my age. I feel so old right now.
I do gaming videos and vlog updates on my channel. Sometimes like goal compilations, if I get a really good goal, I'll put that up.
Because you're a Man United fan, right? He's a Man City fan, yeah. I knew that.
Yeah, I just do video tutorials on how to do stuff on...
You're teaching people how to do stuff, and I don't do that. Like, I don't feel confident enough to do that, and yet, how old are you?
Nine, nearly 10.
Nearly 10. Why did you all start copying me, by the way? I've never asked this.
I taught him.
Yeah, you've got him teaching you. This isn't fair. I didn't have a brother teaching me.
Neither did I. No, I learned off YouTube.
True.
Yeah.
True. So there had to be somebody to begin with. There had to be one person who knew what they were doing.
Yeah.
Then everybody else learned from them.
Yeah.
But there's only allowed to be one YouTuber in the family, so...
No, there isn't.
We're going to have a fight, you realise.
Why?
There can only be one.
There can only be one YouTuber.
It's literally amazing how professional you guys are. Like, I want my channel in the description. Yeah, I want me in the thumbnail.
I want it in the video now.
Yeah. Oh, there's demands now. Like... This will capture what it's like to go on a train in Britain.
When you first took my hand on a cold Christmas Eve, you promised me Broadway was waiting for me.
You're funny!
Oh, thank you, Liv.
So Liv and I are in Bath. We're doing a date, like a full date day. We're going off to... So Bath's where I'm from. So the history of Bath, it's called Bath because the Romans built a spa here. And basically a couple of years ago, they rebuilt like a modern one. And that's where we're going. So we're going to have a bit of chill time as a couple. And you're not coming because you're not seeing me in swim shorts just yet.
I am.
Yeah, you are.
Are you still recording?
Yeah. So as part of our date, we treated ourselves to a Schwartz burger, which is literally the best burger place probably I've ever been to. It's definitely the best takeaway burger I've ever had. If you're in Bath, go to Schwartz burger. This isn't a sponsored message. I just really bloody like their burgers.
That is a prime veggie burger. You rule breaker.
We had a good day.
I feel uncomfortable.
Hang on, I'm just gonna focus your face. There we go.
I feel very uncomfortable.
Why?
Because you're very close and you give me a horrible hot drink.
Simon, how do you deal with being gay on YouTube?
It's really difficult.
Are you enjoying a coffee?
No.
30 service to Edinburgh, Birmingham.
And we're back in the room. I didn't film too much today because, well, this is me and my girlfriend's private time, and especially if you're a vlogger, it's important to keep that separation, I think, between, you know, what you put out there publicly and what you do privately. So a little bit of filming, but not much. Sorry guys, but you know, it's my right to do that. And thus concludes the week. I'll be honest, as I mentioned earlier in the week, YouTube's now getting to the point, and it's a great problem to have, where it is starting to impact on my work. Filming and replying to comments and editing, in addition to all the singing and all the PhD stuff, is really taking its toll. I am incredibly tired. I'm not going to be vlogging next week. I'm probably going to take a couple of weeks off, but I will continue to do this in the new year. I really do enjoy doing vlogging, and I hope that you guys enjoy it, based on how many people are watching these and the lovely comments I've been getting, along with some weird ones, to be fair. But you guys seem to be enjoying it, so I'm going to keep making these and talking about my work and life sort of in equal weight, I guess. Hopefully in the next vlog I will actually have made a bit of progress because I won't be too busy filming all the time. But between now and then I will be doing other things, like for example the book club videos, and doing some other things like more science-based videos, and I think there might be another Harry Potter one coming out. At any rate, this channel is still very much active, and if you're new and watching because of these vlogs, hello, it's really nice to have you on board. Check out some of the other stuff I make, and I'll be making some more vlogs for you in the new year.